Welcome back. I hope you're having an amazing day. Today I'm going to share with you some ways that I have been able to not shop or not fall for any impulse buys. I had a question a little while ago from one of my friends and subscribers on my Instagram, which I will link below if you want to follow us on Instagram. And she asked how I am not buying stuff and how I am dealing with the impulse to want to go shopping. I feel like this is a hard question to answer because everybody is so different. I personally was never a huge shopper. A lot of my clutter, yes, did come from some silly purchases throughout the year, but a lot of my clutter also came from accepting things and just also never decluttering my whole entire life. So that's how my clutter accumulated, and I know a lot of people are really into shopping and finding a really good deal, even antique shopping or secondhand thrifting. And all of that is a great way to find a good deal if you need the items. But if you don't need something, then you have to ask yourself why you are shopping and what you can do to really avoid that feeling of wanting to shop and wanting to bring more things into your home. The first thing I did when I started this decluttering process is I stopped shopping. So I would only go to the store when I needed groceries or some kind of necessity. I quit going to, let's just say, Target to walk around and see what was new because it's just tempting yourself, and then you're having to talk yourself out of items that you see that might just be cute or new, something that you think, oh, this will freshen my house. But for me, I had to ask myself, if I'm decluttering all of these items at home that I once thought were new, cute, now I'm decluttering those items, what am I gonna think when I buy this new item in 6 months' time and it's not new anymore and I'm gonna wanna get rid of that? So it just put everything into perspective and made me realize that I needed to stay out of the stores for a while. The second thing I did is in my email, I unsubscribed from any kind of rewards program or any kind of shopping app. I used to have the Target Cartwheel app, and I just got rid of all of those sales type apps and email lists. I just unsubscribed from all those because even though I wasn't clicking on them necessarily or buying through those links, I just found it was tempting. So if you're in that position where you're really wanting to curb your spending, that's a good way to get started, is just unsubscribe from anything that you feel is tempting you. And if you like it, then keep it. But if it's tempting you and you don't want to be tempted, then I would just unsubscribe. That's an easy way to get the ads, extra ads, out of your site. The third thing I would share with you is I used to be somebody who really liked going to estate sales and garage sales and thrifting. And that was mostly when we first moved into this condo, so 6 years ago. And I just loved finding a good deal, which is great if you need stuff. But at one point I was going and kind of knowing in the back of my head that I didn't need anything, but just going and finding stuff anyway and getting it. And honestly, that is a fun hobby to have, especially if you're into antiques and vintage items, which I really am into those items. But if you're decluttering and you don't want to be spending more money and bringing more items into your home, I would suggest coming up with a different hobby, which is what I did. I started making this YouTube channel, I started working on my blog more. I just focused my energy in a different area, and it was focused less on shopping, thrifting, looking at vintage stuff, and more on creative endeavors that I wanted to work on. And of course, you're going to have a different hobby than I am, but if you can come up with a different hobby that takes the place of shopping, that is one huge way to shift your mind into a different habit. So the thing with habits is if you're in the habit of shopping, you just continue that habit. So if you can break the habit and take up a new creative outlet or something to replace that habit, you will have more success, and I feel that you will find less stuff coming into your home. Another thing that really helped me to quit shopping is with the amount of work it takes to declutter your home. At least for me, it was a lot of work and a lot of time, and the last thing I wanted to do is bring more things into my home that I will have to declutter in 6 months' time. So if you can keep that in mind when you're shopping, that you only want to get items that you can really use or really, really want, because bringing items in that are just a fun purchase for a short time, at least for me, tended to waste money, and I would find myself decluttering those items 6 months later. So just having that perspective in my head really made such a difference. Make sure you click right here to see our entire year of decluttering with before and after footage. And if you're new here, hit the subscribe button to join our Simple Living channel. And I'll see you next time for more inspiration. Bye. Do you have a lot of stuff in your hands?
Yeah.
What is all this?